Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber, Brett Summers, Gary Burkhardt, Chris Stewart, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
Very interesting.
I told you not to breathe on those flowers.
Oh, Gene, I've tell them to... where those flowers came from.
I'll read the card. Hello there, folks. This is, the flowers were sent to Brett Summers. And the card says, for a lovely lady, love, Fanny. Fanny Flagg sent them. Now, why did she send them? These broken down, wilted, beat up, rotten looking flowers.
You know, she actually called a florist and did the whole thing and had them sent. She must have had to say, send a dozen dead roses to Brett Summers.
Not only is it dead, it's dirty. You dirty
dead
rose, you.
Roses.
Well, was she supposed to be on the show today?
Tomorrow.
Yes.
Tomorrow.
She was supposed to be on
this
week.
Or whenever, next week.
This week.
Yeah.
But not
is she all right?
Next week. Yes.
She just did this for a joke for you.
She just did it for a joke.
All right, Ira, you got me out here with these flowers. What do you want me to do with
operation.
Them?
Keep them fresh.
Give them to Brett.
Yeah, keep them fresh.
Keep them fresh. Listen, hi, Mark Breslow, how about up here? Would they look decorate the set a little bit?
Yes.
Could I be a set decorator?
Wait a minute.
Yes, thank
you. Oh, you got it in the wrong place. If you really want the best effect, there's no question about it.
No. Set up for
Fanny. I'm the set decorator.
I see.
And I say they go right there. Well, anyway. I think they're beautiful. Now, let's say hello to Janet Ryan and Sally Brooks. Janet's our current champ. She's won a lot of money. How much money have you won?
$6,300.
Why are you whispering? You don't want your husband to hear about it, huh?
No.
Oh. All right, $6,300. Now, where are we? We're in the middle. We finished round one. It's 3-1 in favor of Sally. And round two is coming up, so don't miss the fun, folks. Come right back. Here we go now. Now, wait a minute. I got to fix my microphone. There we go. Did that hurt? Sorry. Now, push this little button and ask Sally to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. Now, last time, Sally, you matched Brett, Trish, and Richard. So the three of you will lay out, and then Avery, Gary, and Patty will do this. Tinkerbell said... Tinkerbell said,
one thing I've got to remember is not to play blank with Captain Hook. Tinkerbell said that. One thing I've got to remember is not to play blank with Captain Hook.
You know who Tinkerbell is, don't you, Sally?
Yes.
Okay. Do you believe? If you do, you believe. Are you finished? Yes, splendid. How about you? Tinkerbell said,
one thing I've got to remember is not to play blank with Captain...
Oh, you're faked. Okay, all right.
Bong.
Everybody's finished. I'm calling. That's enough.
Bong.
Sally Brooks.
Bong.
Tinkerbell said,
bong. One thing I've got to remember is not to play blank with Captain bong. Hook.
Patty cake?
Patty cake? That's good.
Cakes. Not to play patty cake.
Patty cake. Cakes. She came up with a pretty good answer.
That's terrific.
Oh, if you were playing, you would have said that. All right.
I think she's
Avery, what
terrific.
You say? Isn't that funny? Oh, he's hysterical because this is the fourth show we've done with Avery. And that's the first time he's matched one of our players here, and we're all very happy.
That's
okay,
the first
so that's
time.
One for you, Sally. And now we go to Gary.
Brett was trying to get me to write that, and I'm sorry that I didn't, because it's a good... I said ping pong.
Ping pong.
That hook okay. shot will get you every time. Broomchak.
Broomchak. We're up to four, and we call on Patty Deutsch.
Also known as Patty Cake.
Patty Cake. Okay. Now, Janet. Score at this moment is 5-1. You need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Here we go. The Texan says,
I don't like to brag that my new car is big, but you can actually blank in the glove compartment. I mean to tell you, that's some big car.
Texan said that.
Texan said that. Gary, you lay out this time, boy.
Yes, sir, I certainly
Boy, don't
will.
You do nothing. You just sit there, and I'm going to give you some help when you need the help.
Thank you.
But you don't need no help now.
I know what you mean. I had a car like that once myself.
You need some help?
Yeah.
You look pretty hep to me.
The car that was so big you could. What?
I don't like to brag that my new car is big, but you can actually blank in the glove compartment. That big Texan said that.
He did.
He said that,
when
right.
When did he say that?
He said that last week.
Was he on the turnpike?
No, no.
No, he didn't turn his pike.
Oh, well, it's been pretty big.
Yes. All right, everybody ready? ready.
I reckon.
Now, Janet Ryan. Texan said, I don't like to brag that my new car is big, but you can actually blank in the glove compartment.
Sleep?
Sleep in the glove compartment. Well, we'll see. I don't know. Maybe yes, maybe no. Who knows?
I feel I've hit my peak.
Yeah. It's downhill again.
That's funny. You don't look it.
I said barbecue.
Barbecue. Barbecue in the glove compartment. All right, I got to match everybody else to stay in the game. Janet, now we go to Gary.
No,
we don't go to Gary.
No, we go to Brett. No, we don't go to Gary.
Go to Brett?
Hi.
Hello there. I remember you. Have you got an answer for the lady? She's looking for the answer, sleep.
Am I
the... Just stay in the game. You're the critical one.
You don't. Would you like me? I could do a little drawing
no,
for
no,
you.
No. Just, pick up the card and put it there and show and tell.
I said swim.
Swim! So it's got to go. Swim today. What is the rest of you have here? Sleep, sleep. But she's got a smile on her face.
Yes,
because
yes,
she's got her $6,300, which is hers. Yay for Janet! Yay. Nice to see you, Janet.
Bye.
Goodbye. Now, you get ready for the big money super match here, and while you're getting set, we'll have this word of interest, okay? Now, we're going to have Sally Brooks up here and have a go at the big money super match. Are you all set?
Yes.
Okay. Here's the way it goes, Sally. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank, blonde. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Now, if you match the next one, you get $250. The third gives you $100. Three celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Why do you say that?
What I was when I was a baby, a dumb blonde.
A dumb blonde.
I was very attractive.
Were you a blonde?
And Patty?
Patty?
A bleached blonde.
A bleached blonde. All right.
And Trish?
A platinum blonde.
Platinum blonde. So you got a dumb blonde, you got a bleached blonde, and you got a platinum blonde. You want one of those, or you want to give us one of your own?
I want dumb.
You want dumb blonde. All right. She says it's up there. And hopefully she says it's under the $500 response. But we'll start down at the bottom and find out first. May we see the $100 response? Bleached blonde. That's the one that Patty gave you. All right. That may be a good omen, Sally. Who knows? We are looking for dumb blonde. Here is the $250 response. Dumb blonde it is. Congratulations. You got the $250. Very good. What do you think's under the big one there? What?
Platinum.
Satisfied.
You're allergic to them, aren't you?
Platinum.
You are
right. That's a very smart audience. Excuse me for sneezing in your face like that. I don't have any diseases. You're not going to get the flu or anything like that because I'm a very healthy fellow.
You might,
now,
might get a little rash.
You got the $250. You're going to play for $2,500 now. But before we can give you that amount of money, you have to match one of them ding-a-lings head-to-head. It has to be an exact match. Which one do you choose?
Richard.
You choose Richard. All right. You face me, Sally. I got the $2,500 question, which reads as follows. Blank, peck. P-E-C-K.
Okay, he's finished. Now, Sally, we call on you for your response to this blank. In an attempt to match him, what would you put in that blank? Blank Peck.
Gregory.
Gregory? The audience agrees with you. Now we'll find out if you have matched Richard indeed for $2,500. Sir, may we see your answer?
I was just thinking of that song. I love you,
a bushel and a peck.
No, wrong words. A Gregory and a peck.
You ready?
Yes.
Shall we carry on?
Sure.
Okay, she's got a lot of money. She's got a happy brother out there and friends. Now let's welcome Vivian Ridgway. Vivian, hello, Sally. Now we'll find out a little bit about Vivian Ridgway, shall we?
Yes, I live in Los Angeles. I'm married to a wonderful man. We have two lovely boys, and I work... And I'm a housewife.
Oh, go ahead, you can remember.
All those things together. And believe it or not, I'm a buyer for a hydraulic accumulator firm.
A what? You're a what?
A buyer for a hydraulic accumulator firm.
She's a buyer for a hydraulic accumulator.
What? It goes like this.
No wonder the world is going to pot.
No wonder.
The women
no wonder.
Buying hydraulic accumulators.
No wonder people are
and
accumulating.
I'm good at it, too.
I'll bet you are. Whatever it is. Congratulations. We need more women buying hydraulic accumulators.
Yeah.
That's what we need, right?
Try it.
Right. Oh, this last week. Yeah!
What the heck is a hydraulic accumulator?
Oh, there. Haven't you been to the airport and see the hydraulic lifts? All those things. Anything that's hydraulic. We manufacture it.
Okay.
I buy the component for it.
I think I've learned more than I care to know. What hydraulic accumulators there?
Tell me something.
What?
Why is that
no.
funny to him?
Is this an old burlesque routine?
No, that's not an old burlesque routine.
It's accumulated.
Shall
the
we begin?
The guy comes along and says, yeah, but why is it so yellow?
And ask Vivian to make a selection.
A, please.
A. Here we go. Everybody plays. Ready.
Why is he laughing?
Because I don't know.
That's the funniest profession I've ever heard.
Hydraulic accumulator.
Other than being an actor, of course.
Here it is. At the hobo camp, Annie said to Hank. This is at the hobo camp. Annie said to Hank.
Hobo what?
Camp.
Hobo camp.
Thank you.
You know, as in high camp, low camp.
Right. Annie said to Hank, this tea you just brewed is awful. How did you make it? And Hank said, well, I didn't have a tea bag, so I steeped my blank in a pot of hot water. Have you ever seen a hobo camp?
I wish I were dead.
Okay.
Yeah.
You've seen a hobo camp.
Sure, they go, whee.
No.
Well, that's how they camp when I saw them.
Yeah, no, that's how they camp on Hollywood Boulevard.
Well, hobos.
Yeah. Did you hear all that, Vivian? Okay, you think about it while they're finished. Oh, they're all finished. All finished. All right, Patty's ready. At the hobo camp, Annie said to Hank, this tea you just brewed is awful. How did you make it? And Hank said, well, I didn't have a tea bag, so I steeped my blank in a pot of hot water.
Cigar.
Cigar. That's not bad. Don't awe her. Leave her alone. She's okay. She said, hello there, through the roses. Oh, you're lovely.
Dead roses.
No.
For a blue lady.
No. I don't know if my cigar.
You don't?
No, but I've done what I've done. Well, anyhow, I didn't have. I'm sorry, babe. I had socks.
Socks.
How do you like that?
All right.
I was sure Avery had it. With that.
So you wrote it down?
No, I actually when you, I said sock too.
Oh, you did.
Or
oh.
Strike, hit,
all right.
Stomp
cigar,
on.
Cigar, I think, was a very good answer. Anybody else any for a cigar there? Are you offering a cigar?
No, the most logical one that I could think of was hydraulic accumulator, actually.
He pushes the buzzer.
Well, we were just kidding you. See, we did a little joke there. Hydraulic.
I said,
what?
Wait a minute. How's this?
Good.
No! I'm sorry. I said sock too.
Oh. See, I thought cigar was a good answer. All this is coming up socks here. What do you say there, Trish?
I thought cigar was, too.
But. A butt. Cigar butt.
Hey.
There's one for you. Well done, my dear. You know,
you saved that one.
If you unroll a cigar, it'd look like tea leaves. That's why I thought cigar was good. What do you think?
The word was tea bag, wasn't it? I figured he had tea.
Oh, I see.
That's okay. Why I joined the Avery group of dancers and wrote
the Avery Schreiber School of Modern Dance. What do you say?
I said cigar butt.
Cigar butt! That's two for you.
How pleasant.
Hey, you get ready for your question. In the meantime, we'll get ready for this message for you. Here it is. Okay, now, second half of round one. You ready for this, Sally?
Yes.
All right, listen carefully. She did pretty well with hers, scored two. Here we go, Sally's first round. Marie said, my husband, the animal trainer, has finally lost his mind. He just spent the last 6 months trying to teach a blank to tap dance.
Say that again.
Marie said, my husband, the animal trainer, has finally lost his mind. He just spent the last 6 months trying to teach a blank to tap dance. He's an animal trainer, you see.
He trains animals, as in, you know, training.
And he went bananas trying to teach a blank to tap dance.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I got it.
Don't yawn at these questions. We pay writers up to $1.39 to write this brilliant humorous.
For how many questions?
You go for it, all right?
Look at the little mother.
Okay. Now, we come over here to Sally Brooks.
Way to talk.
Marie said, my husband, the animal trainer, has finally lost his mind. He just spent the last 6 months trying to teach a blank to tap dance.
Elephant?
An elephant? That would be hard, wouldn't it?
Yes.
She says it would be difficult to teach elephant, but when you hear some of these answers, wait till you hear some of these answers. All right. The first one may be the most shocking. Okay, Avery, you're on.
Well, first I thought an octopus.
An octopus would be very difficult.
But I decided against it.
Yes.
I chose a monkey.
A monkey.
I'm sorry, Dave.
Not so hard. Go, give him a good answer.
To think he was humming in his dressing room. Luck be a lady tonight.
It's been busy.
Why, what do you think I said? I said elephant.
Oh, she said elephant. That's one for you. Gary?
Well, I'm sorry I didn't say elephant.
What did you say?
I was thinking of chimpanzee and I said gorilla.
A gorilla.
You know, they keep
that would be difficult.
Like bananas.
All right. Now, you really haven't come to the most difficult task yet. Maybe Trish will show you what a difficult task is.
Well, I thought that he'd pick something that was dressed for the part. A penguin.
A penguin.
I'm putting on my top hat.
It's another Avery Schreiber type answer.
Eating
a
penguin.
Jumping on my wall.
That'd now, be interesting. Ginger Rogers and Fred Elephant.
Yes.
See, if he's going to go crazy, it would have to be something with no feet.
Right.
Right?
Right.
That's like trying to throw a boomerang away.
Right. Such as?
El Snaco.
Snake! You just saved the whole show from going down the drain, Dawson.
Oh, well, I'll withdraw it then. Let's all go together.
All right, Deutsch.
Oh, hello. I once saw an elephant tap dance.
You didn't?
Yes, and it wasn't pretty. No, I said he tried to teach a fish to tap dance.
That would be hard. Yeah, a centipede, a fish, a snake, anything,
sponge.
You know, would be difficult. All right, so at the end of round
animals.
One, we have a score of 2-1. Favor of Vivian, who will now make a selection.
A again, please.
A again? No, two people do not play. Who are they? Trish and Patty. The rest do. The cowboy... was so absent-minded.
How absent-minded was he, Gene?
I'll tell you how absent-minded he was.
How?
He put his girlfriend in the barn and took his horse to blank.
He put his girlfriend in the barn and what?
He put his girlfriend in the barn and took his horse to blank.
I'm glad I'm not answering that question.
You don't want to play? Really? Come on.
Oh,
just for the
heck
of it.
Oh, well.
Just a little game between you and me.
Oh, all right.
You write your answer? Okay, that'd be interesting. Right. All right. Gary, you ready?
Yes, sir.
Here we go. That's all right. Presto. Everybody ready. Now, Vivian. The cowboy was so absent-minded, he put his girlfriend in the barn and took his horse to blank.
To bed.
To bed. Did you hear what that lady said?
Did I hear what that lady said?
Yes.
What do you say?
Luck be a lady. Oh!
Okay. Your kid'll be proud of you. Josh, you'll love that. All right, yes. Brett.
I'm batting 1,000, honey. Bam.
Very good. Two for you, Gary. What do you got?
I'm betting 0. I said to the square dance.
To the square dance. All right, Dawson, it's up to you.
Could have been worse. He could have said Tijuana, Betty Bynes.
Betty Bynes. That's 5 for you. Okay, middle of round 2, 5-1, favor of Vivian. Your question is coming up. You'll have to have 4 to tie, 5 to win. Now this message for you. You ding-a-ling, I didn't want these flowers down here. I just wanted them. Besides,
you look like you're about to be buried.
Yeah, you take the flowers. We just have a few seconds. I just want to thank the kind young ladies in the studio audience who made this sign, who think very highly of our show, and they are Carol, Sandy, Debbie, and Darlene, and they're here. And these are real lollipops, and they like our program, and we like them. Match game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking.
Our show, and they are Carol, Sandy, Debbie, and Darlene, and they're here. And these are real lollipops, and they like our program, and we like them. Match game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.